Hello friends, this is Rohit from careerdost.in. Welcome to our YouTube channel CareerDost. The topic that we are going to look on today is train problems, speed, distance and time, basics and methods, examples, shortcuts and math tricks. So let's get started. So as you see in any aptitude exam, you will find at least one train problem. Today I will tell you the four types of train problems that you need to know. Anything apart from this is not necessarily part of the exam. So these are the basic problems you should definitely know, which are: type 1 is conversion, type 2 is time and distance formula, type 3 is train and object, and type 4 is theory of relativity. So let's get started and explore each type one by one. So first type is conversion. You might have seen it is very common and you might have faced these type of problems in many exams. So there are two types of conversion. One is kilometer to meter per second, and other one is meter per second to kilometer per hour. So when you have to convert kilometer to meter per second, we have to multiply it by 5 by 18, and when we have to convert it from meter per second to kilometer per hour, we have to multiply it by 18 by 5. So when the question is to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, always multiply by 5 by 18, and when the question says to convert it from meter per second to kilometer per hour, always multiply it by 18 by 5. So people get a lot of confusion multiplying by 5 by 18 or 18 by 5. So there is a simple way to remember. If your answer needs to be in meter per second, so remember meter is the smallest unit when compared to kilometer. So if it's meter, always remember smallest number 5 will be in the numerator. And similarly, kilometer is the higher unit compared to meter. So when you have to convert kilometer in your answer, you will be having highest numerator. Simple to remember, right? So let's see type 2. So type 2 of train problem is time and distance formula. So the formula to remember here is S is equal to d by t, where S is speed, d is distance and t is time. As you might have seen, this is the most common question that you can face in any aptitude exam. So they will either give you distance and the time and ask you speed, or they will give you speed and time and ask you distance, or vice versa. So this is the basic formula one must know for train problems. So let's just solve a simple problem to understand the formula better. So the question is, a train is 300 meter long and runs at 60 meter per second. Find t, where t is time. So when you see a question, always write whatever is given so that you don't make a mistake. Here we can say we have length of the train, which is 300 meter. We are denoting it by the letter L, and distance. So length is nothing but the distance covered by the train, and we have the speed, which is 60 meter per second. So now we know the formula. The speed is distance by time, and we have to find time. So now after putting the values, we can say that time is equal to 300 by 60, which is equal to 5 seconds, right? So they could give you two variables and ask you the third variable in the speed, distance and time formula. So let's come to the third type of train problem, that is train and object. So in train and object type of problem, there are two types of problems. One is a train crossing pole or a man or a tree, and another type is when a train is crossing a bridge, tunnel or platform. So let's get started. When a train is crossing the pole, a man or the tree, so we know the formula is S is equal to d by t. So in distance covered by the train, let's say this is the train and this is the pole or tree, whatever you want to call it. So let's say the distance covered by the train to cross this tree is the length of the train. So when we say that the train has covered the tree, then it has covered this distance, right? And the back of the train comes here. So when we say when the train has crossed the tree and it has covered this distance, and the back of the train comes here, we can say it has crossed the pole or the tree or the man. So this becomes the length of the train, which has completely crossed. So S will be equal to d by t, which we know. So in this case, it will be equal to L by t, which is the length of the train. Now let's see what happens when a train crosses a bridge, tunnel or a platform. So let's say this is the train and this is the bridge or a tunnel or a platform, whichever you may consider. So the length of the train is L1 and length of the bridge is L2. So when will you say that the train has completely crossed the bridge? When the back of the train comes here, right? So at this point of time, you will say that train has completely crossed the bridge. So the distance traveled by the train will be S is equal to D by T, which will be length of the train 1 plus length of the bridge L2 upon T. So this becomes the formula when a train crosses a bridge, tunnel or platform. Alright, so let's solve some of the problem to make it more clear. So let's say we have a train that is 400 meter long and is running at a speed of 72 km per hour. In what time it will pass a bridge of 200 meter long? So as I always say, first write whatever data is given. So we know that we have the length of the train, which is 400 meter, and we have the length of the bridge, which is 200 meter. And what else we have? We have the speed, which is 72 km per hour. Now what we have to find is the time. Time is asked. There is one more thing. So as you can see, the length of the train and the length of the bridge is in meters, but speed is in kilometer. So first we have to convert it into meter per second. So speed will be equal to 72 into 5 by 18 because we have to convert it to meter per second. So we will multiply it by 5 by 18, which gives us 20 meter per second. Now we have the speed in meter per second. So now speed is equal to distance by time, and here it will be LT plus LB, or we can say L1 plus L2 by T, which will give us L1 plus L2 is 400 plus 200, which gives us 600, and 20 is the speed, which will give us time as 30 seconds. So what we did in this question, we have been given length of the train and the length of the bridge. So we know we have to use the formula L1 plus L2 by T in this case. Speed was given in kilometer per hour, whereas length was given in meters. So we converted the speed into meter per second by multiplying it with the conversion of 5 by 18. And after that, we equate it in the equation L1 plus L2 by T, and hence got the value of T as 30 seconds. So let's move ahead. So there is one more problem. It says a train covers 40 km in 30 minutes. If it takes 9 seconds to pass a telegraph post, the length of the train is. So let's write whatever is given. Distance is given, that is 40 km. Time is given 30 minutes. So distance is in kilometers, as we can see, and time is in minutes. So let's convert it first. So we know speed is equal to distance by time. Now we have to convert it. So as we are converting it to meter per second, so we have to multiply it by 1000, 30 into 60, because we have to convert to seconds. So we get as 400 upon 18, which will give us 200 by 9. So now the second part of the question is, if it takes 9 seconds to pass a telegraph post, the length of the train is. So we know that the time taken is 9 seconds, and we know the speed of the train, which 200 by 9. Now we need to find the length of the train. So let's use the formula distance by time, or L by T. So L will be equal to S into T, and we know the speed of the train and time, which is 9 seconds. So we get 200 by 9, which is the speed, into 9, which will give us the length of the train, and hence length of the train we get it as 200 meter. So let's move ahead. So next question is, a train moves past a man and a bridge of 320 meter in 7 seconds and 12 seconds. What is the speed of the train? So in the previous two problems, we dealt with the single object and the bridge problem separately. In this question, both are together. It's a bit tricky, but if you understand the concept, it will be very easy. So first, let's write whatever is given. So train moves past a man. Speed is equal to distance by time. So we can write it as length of the train speed into time, which is 7 seconds. So the time taken by the train to cross the man is 7 seconds. So we know that the distance is the length of the train here. So we will put it as speed into time, and time is 7 seconds. So this is our equation 1. Second is, train moves past a bridge. So we know bridge will be, speed will be equal to D by T, and here length of the train plus length of the bridge, which will be equal to 12 seconds. Speed into 12. 12 is the time taken to move past a bridge. So the length here is length of the train plus length of the bridge, and time taken to cross it, we don't know the speed. Now we know the length of the bridge is 320 meters. So we can write it as length of the train plus 320 is equal to speed into 12. So this can be our equation 2. So we have two equations. Now we can simplify it. So by substituting the values of LT, which we got in equation 1, we can put it in equation 2. So we will get it like 7s plus 320 is equal to 12s, and upon solving we will get s is equal to 65 meter per second, which will be our speed. So now we have found the speed of the train that will cross a man as well as the bridge. So these are the three types of train problems that we have dealt now. Now let's move ahead. Now we will look on the fourth type of train problem. So fourth type of train problem is theory of relativity. So there are two types of theory of relativity. One is train moving in opposite direction. Another one is train moving in the same direction. So let's say first for the opposite direction. Let's say we have a train T1 with length L1 moving with a speed of U1, and we have a train T2 length of L2 moving with a speed of V1. So we know the formula is S is equal to d by t. So what is the time taken for the two trains moving in the opposite direction to cross each other completely? So in this case, what we say is that the rear part of the train cross each other. That is when we say that the two trains has crossed each other completely. So always it has to cover L1 as well as L2 to cover the distance. So t is equal to distance by speed, which is L1 plus L2 upon U1 plus V1. So what about the speed? We know that it will always be U1 plus V1. But lot of people don't know why it is like that. So let's say you are moving in a train. When you see the opposite train, even though it goes with a speed much lesser than your train, you will always feel that it is going at a much higher speed. Why it is so? It is so because the addition of the speed of your train plus the other train that takes place. So this train and this train. So let's say, for example, your train is at 80 km per hour and the other train is at 40 km per hour. So when the train crosses each other, you will feel that the other train is at much higher speed. But in reality, it is not. This happens because your train speed, which is at 80 km per hour, and the other train speed, which is at 40 km per hour, adds up. So both speeds just adds up. So you might feel that the speed is 120 km per hour. So this is the reason why we add up the speed when the trains are moving in opposite direction. So T is equal to D by S, or in this scenario L1 plus L2 by U1 plus V1. So let's go to the same direction, or we can say parallel direction. So let's say train 1 with the length L1 and train 2 with length L2, train 1 moving with the speed of U1 and train 2 moving with the speed of V1. So we know that we subtract the speeds here. S is equal to D by T, T is equal to D by S, L1 plus L2 by U1 minus V1. So we know the formula that we subtract the speeds here, but why? So let's say you are going in a train and you see a train coming in the same direction of your train. So if you are going at 60 km per hour and that train is also going at 60 km per hour, so both trains are at the same speed. So you will feel that both trains are not moving and you get confused at that time. So why that happens? That's because 60 minus 60 becomes 0. So that is the reason we subtract the speeds in the case of same direction. Hence L1 plus L2 by U1 minus V1 for same direction, and L1 plus L2 by U1 plus V1 for opposite direction. So now you might have understood the concept of train moving in the opposite direction and train moving in the same direction. So now let's solve some questions to understand it better. So we have the question: two trains 120 meter and 180 meter long at S1 equal to 66 km per hour and S2 is equal to 42 km per hour moving in opposite direction on parallel tracks. What is the time to cross each other? So first let's write what is given. Length of the train 1 is 120 meter and length of the train 2 is 180 meter, and speed of train 1 is 66 km per hour and speed of train 2 is 42 km per hour. So as we can see, it is going in opposite direction, right? So sometimes people get confused when they say parallel tracks. So parallel tracks here means that they are coming on parallel tracks but in opposite direction, alright? So we know that both trains are coming from opposite direction, so we have to add the speeds here. So S1 plus S2 will be equal to 66 plus 42, which makes a total of 108 km per hour. But the catch here is that the length is in meter. So you can see the length is in meter and the speed is in kilometer. So we need to convert it. So 108 into 5 by 18 to convert it to meter per second will give us 30 meter per second. So now we know the speed, we know the distance. So let's find time now. So the formula for finding time when the trains are moving in opposite direction is T is equal to L1 plus L2 upon S1 plus S2, which will give us 120 plus 180, which will give us 300. And we have already found S1 plus S2, which is 30 meter per second. So we can easily find time, which is equal to 10 seconds. So what we did in this question is, we know the length of the train 1, we know the length of the train 2, which were already given in the question. Speed 1 and speed 2 were also given. The trains were coming from the opposite direction, so we know that speed needs to be added. Catch here was the length were in meter and speed was in kilometer, so we converted it by the conversion formula by multiplying it by 5/18. So we got 30 meter per second as the speed. Now we know that time for two trains coming from the opposite direction would be L1 plus L2 upon S1 plus S2. So we know the length of the trains, which was already given in the question, and we found the speed. So we just put the values here and we found the time as 10 seconds. So let's move to the other question. So other question is, two trains of equal length are running on parallel lines in the same direction at S1 is equal to 50 km per hour and S2 is equal to 30 km per hour. Faster train passes the slower train in 20 seconds. Find the length of the train. So thing is, two trains of equal length are running on parallel lines in the same direction. So we have to subtract the speeds here. So whenever we see same direction, we need to subtract the speeds. So 50 minus 30 will give us 20 km per hour. So this will be the speed. So it's in km per hour. But the time is given in seconds. So we need to convert it to meter per second. So what we will do, we will multiply it by 5/18. So we will get 50/9 meter per second as the speed. What else they have given is, faster train passes the slower train in 20 seconds. Find the length. There is one more thing. Trains are of equal length. So we can say L1 is equal to L2. So now we know S is equal to D by T, or S is equal to L1 plus L2 by T. Or we can say, since L1 and L2 are equal, we can say 2L1 by T. So now we need to equate the values, because we know the speed, which is 50/9, and we know the time, which is 30 seconds. So we'll just put the values here and simplify it. So 2 goes 10 times in 20. So now we get it as L1 is equal to 500/9, and upon solving, we'll get 55.55 meters. So what we did in this question was, length of the train were equal. Second thing was, they were running on the parallel lines but in the same direction. So we know we have to subtract the speeds here. So sometimes to confuse you, they will ask you what is the length of the faster train or the length of the slower train. But as we know, both are of equal length. So be it faster or slower, length will be the same. So we have covered all four types of train problems in this video. If you are thorough with all these concepts, there is nothing more that can be asked in any train problems in any aptitude exam. So that's it guys. Hope you enjoyed the video on train problems, speed, distance and time relation, and the four concepts we discussed here. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please like us and subscribe to us. We are making similar videos in aptitude categories. Thank you.